Hi, welcome to my channel. So today we're going to play RimWorld. RimWorld is basically a game where you micromanage your colonists to live in a world where other colonists attack you as well. So let's get started, shall we? So let's create a new colony and start on the crash landed scenario. Our storyteller is gonna be, let's pick Cassandra Classic, and let's choose Blood and Dust. Basically just above average difficulty, and let's pick reload anytime mode so that we could load saves. Let's not tamper with this. I'm just gonna increase the population so that we get more settlements nearby. So now let's pick our settlement. As you can see, there's a lot of settlements too. There's a lot of, we have a lot of so first we want a colonist who's intelligent, but not this guy, because as you can see his traits is sickly, which means he has an awful immune system. He's more prone to getting sick or getting illnesses, but it also increases his medical skill. So it's really all about balancing your colonist's overall skills and traits. And as you can see here, he has multiple scars, which is bad because as you can see it decreases efficiency. And also when you have this type of scar, which is aching, it also is bad because it has a mood debuff, which your colonists will be more prone to mood breaks, which is bad, and we don't want that to happen. So let's randomize some colonists. This one is pretty good, although he is a psychopath, which is not really bad. He has great memory, so he will retain this skills. He is tough, so he is more resilient to damage. I don't think I want this guy, but let's see other colonists. I don't want this guy. No, I want a colonist as good at construction and mining. Let's see, let's find mine. More? No. Finally, we found a colonist who is pretty good at construction and mining, so we're gonna keep him. His name is Ramon Bison, and let's randomize until we get a guy who's good at crafting, plants, and cooking. we found a guy, a female rather, who's pretty good at crafting plants, not much at cooking, but we're gonna edit that with the prepare carefully and decrease the mining and basically transfer all of this into cooking. So let's randomize. Let's find another researcher. Ooh! This one! Oh my god, we got that pretty quick. This guy is pretty good. I mean, female rather. He has a drilling arm, which we're gonna remove. Yeah, this guy is pretty good. Let's go into prepare carefully and remove that arm. Now we're gonna transfer that to anybody. We're just gonna transfer this into medical just for the compensation that we removed the drill arm. Let's decrease this for a bit. Remove the artistic and maybe increase cooking. And looks like, oh yeah, this woman. Let's decrease mining, transfer it to plants, and transfer this passion here, so that she has double passion. Let's remove relationships. I don't like relationships. And looks like we're pretty good. We're pretty alright, actually. Ooh, this. She can't fight, though. That's alright. We're gonna train them. Let's start with our comments. The three of you awake in your cryptoclick sarcophagy to the sound of sirens and ripping metal. You barely get to escape pods before the ship is torn apart. Sometime later you land on this unknown rim world as pieces of the shredded starship fall around you. You start making plans to survive. So now, our main objective is to survive and get out of this planet. Looks like we landed on a pretty great spot. Although there's a lot of shrines or steel. Is that how you pronounce it? I don't know. So this looks like a pretty great spot. Plus, we have a large amount of rich soil around this spot. We also have steam geysers, which is a source of power, which is great. So let's make a stockpile so that we can place this stuff on a pretty secure spot. Let's forbid the steel. Oh my god, we also have Brittany. Oh my god, look at this guy. That's gonna be our protagonist. So let's who's good at shooting? I'd say both of them equip ranged weapons, and unfortunately Unai cannot fight, but he has pretty good traits otherwise, so again, let's create the stockpile. Just right about here, I would say. That's pretty good. And let's surround that with wooden walls. Now let's put the door here. And let's organize our work tab. Set it to manual property. Let's have them firefly, patient on second priority, Unai on first priority of being a doctor, and basically have them all home, and basically just set them to their abilities, set their jobs according to their abilities. This, of course, research one on Unai, and hopefully we start seeing Ramon build the walls, the wooden walls. Let's chop the surrounding wood so that we have extra wood lying around for us to build. Cryptosleep sickness, which decreases his health, moving, consciousness, manipulation, talking, eating, which is bad because we want him to build the walls right about now. Looks like he botched one wall, which is fine, although we lost a bit of wood. We're chopping, Cyrus chopping wood anyway, so it doesn't really matter. Let's set a rice field so that we have food. We have a source of food. I think that's enough. Let's select rice plant, and Sarah should start planting rice. He's leveling up his plant skills pretty quickly. Let's build a barrack just so that it's easier for us to manage, just to save resources. Let's build a barrack, just a small one, doesn't need to be a large barrack, because that would be expensive and you don't want to waste resources. Let's place end tables here. Let's make a barrack a little bit bigger so that we can fit this wooden dresser here. Let's also build a research table so that we can already start researching. Let's research solar panels and batteries. Like we're having a pretty great start, although Daryl, what are you doing? Plan. Oh my god. What a lazy bum. Let's build a recreation for them so that their mood will increase. Just this horseshoe spin would be great, or would be enough for them. I should assign their schedule. Let's have them recreate for 5 hours and work for these amount of hours, 8 hours, and recreate for 3 hours again. Let's designate a spot for cotton, because we're gonna need it to make flak armor, so that we are a bit defensive against bullets. Let's also assign a glowing zone. Maybe just 5x5 would be enough for heal roots, so that we can treat wounds early on in game. Although we are lacking wood, we consume wood so fast. Oh my god. Let's cancel force work. At Brittany here, just chilling and relaxed. We don't have a colonist who has a pretty good handling trait, skill, I mean, which is not good, because we want the same animal so that we could trade with other settlements as well. That's a bit concerning on my side. Ramon is at minor breakfast, which is concerning, but it's gonna go up pretty quickly. One of our colonists seems to be going to break easily, except for Ramon. All of them are getting along pretty quickly, surprisingly, you know. Looks like Sarah is up early to plan. Right. Which is great. Let's expand this a bit so that we get more cotton, and let's remove this stuff over here. Let's deconstruct them and the floors as well, so that we can plant more section, the research, this research spot, so that we can roof, this, and we won't have the work speed penalty. Wow, Ramon is working pretty quick and is not botching any construction lately, which is impressive. It's probably because he has level 11 on his construction skills. That is impressive indeed. Let's just expand this cotton field just a bit, and our rice field too. I'm gonna find a place for this bone cutter's table. Look at this place. I guess over here would be a pretty good place, and that's built around it so that we don't get the penalty debuff. Soon we're gonna get attacked by raiders, and we need defense to defend ourselves with. And looks like we have more steel here, but we're gonna need to isolate ourselves. Start off by blocking this spot here and here. I'm not sure if raiders can go through doors, but just in case they can, I'm gonna block that off. I'm gonna block all entry points, and we want to isolate raiders in a pretty tight spot so that we can easily kill them. Right here would be alright. Guessing right here. And let's build this long corridor so that we have time to ready ourselves when the raider comes. Let's place wooden doors around this wall so that it's easier to get in and out. I almost forgot we have this open space here. Let's block it off. There. Let's wait for Ramon to finish building. Looks like Ramon and Sarah are now partners or lovers, and they need to be in the same bed together. So there's a quick solution for that. Let's build a bedroom here right beside our research spot. Let's place. Build that. Well, we wait for a month to finish building what we plan. Let's chop some trees. Guessing that would be enough. Yeah, I think that's enough. Let's assign someone to make a stone block. And let's build a tool cabinet so that the work speed is going to be pretty fast. Look at these two lovers. Let's save, just in case. And looks like a group of travelers from Monjedo. We don't want to capture them because it will anger the faction. Though they have good traits. I don't like their skills. So what I'm gonna be doing off camera is have Ramon build this stuff, all these walls, so that we are ready when the raiders come. And that's it for today's episode. I'll see you guys on the next one.